Hi everyone, and welcome to this tutorial that is going to be showing you a difference between a radius circle done in distance versus a time-based isochrone. It's one that we're kind of commonly asked here at TravelTime about how we can demonstrate kind of the differences in areas and reachable areas between a time-based isochrone and then also a simple circular and more commonly used radius circle. So as you can see, I've got QGIS up here. And what we're gonna be using today is a couple of different plugins that are free to download from the plugin manager in QGIS. So the first one we'll be using is mmqgis. So you can just download this from up here in the plugins. If you go to manage and install plugins, apologize, my double screen here. I'll drag that over there. So if you just type in, as you can see, I've just done it before, mmqgis, you can then install that plugin so you can utilize it. The other one that we'll be using is TravelTime. So TravelTime, again, you can just find it from the manage and install plugins. Type in TravelTime. Alternatively, you can go onto traveltime.com /docs/QGIS. And there you'll also be able to find a little bit more about the TravelTime plugin and documentation around that and how to use it. Our first step and what we're going to do, as you can see here, is we're in the UK, we're in London. And I've got a couple of just preset point layers that I'll use. I'll just use this one location here towards Angel to demonstrate this radius circle and then the travel time isochrone. So first of all, what we're going to use is come up to mmqgis and we're going to go to create and we're going to create a buffer. So if we open this up and what we're going to want to do, just quickly tick that so that we can utilize it. So what we're going to want to do is by creating this buffer, we're going to create a radius circle around this one location. So as you can see here, the input layer is going to be that one location, which is situated around Angel. The next thing we are going to do is we're going to come down here and go around the distance that you want around this point layer. So 1 mile here is fine. You're able to change it into kilometers, meters, etc. We'll stick with miles here. And you can also just make sure, by default, I believe it goes to 32. So that's the number of edges around the circle. We're going to go 64 because we want it as smooth as possible. Don't worry about the fixed degrees of rotation there. So just remember then when you're doing the output file name, just to make sure you're saving it in an appropriate place. Otherwise it doesn't really work properly. So here I've just got a QGIS folder and I'm happy to leave it as is there. I might just make this a different name. File. Save that. And then it's as easy as just clicking apply here. So now if we X out of this, you'll see we've got our 1 mile radius circle. Obviously, it's quite a blocked out color, so we're not going to want to see that on top of the map. So we'll double click on here. Again, unfortunately, my screen's just coming over here. And what we're going to want to do is just bring down the opacity of that so it's a bit see through. So if we click OK, there we go. And there you can see you've got your 1 mile. Radius circle just around that point. You can do this kind of as many times as you like. So again, it's probably quite helpful to show a number. So if we just do 5 miles this time, make sure that that's centered around that one location that we did the original one in also. And here you can just now just go down and just change that saved file and we'll make it 5 miles here. So we know what shape is where. And what distance it's going to be doing. So if we apply that again, and here you can already see it's poking up, we get a much larger circle, giving you a 5 mile radius around this point layer. And again, we're just going to open this up and change the opacity of it. Go down to 40 again and click OK. And there you can see the 5 mile radius around that. So I won't do another one. I think 5 miles is probably fine for now, those two. So now what we want to do is kind of compare that to a travel time isochrone shape. So the travel time isochrone shape does is kind of, as the title says, it will give you an area and by time, depending on what time you put, to show which area is reachable. So we call it an isochrone. You could call it a retail trade area or something of the sort. Or time map is kind of how we traditionally call it. So essentially what we're going to do is, we're going to have downloaded that QGIS plugin, so the travel time QGIS plugin. And as you can see up here, you're going to kind of get a few easy kind of quick use tools on the toolbar up here. There's also more advanced features. If you want to learn a bit more about that, please just go to the documents page or the QGIS documents page on traveltime.com and you'll be able to read more about how to use these different tools. There's a few different tools you can use. Today, we're just going to use the most simple work version, which is the time map, and that's just accessible up here on the toolbar. So as you can see, we're just going to utilize this, the time map. And what we're going to do is we're just going to click this down bar. There's four modes of transport that you can use from this very simple kind of time map tool on the toolbar. The first being walking, the next being cycling, and then also driving and public transport. For the purpose of this, let's use public transport because public transport is essentially the way most people get around in London and commute to London. So as you can see, just got the public transport there. You can go up to about 2 to 4 hours, depending on kind of what plan you have and what you're using. For the purposes of this tutorial, we're just gonna do 60 minutes. And if we just go, we want to leave, let's say we wanna arrive at this point. Let's say that we're looking at a kind of a office location that we want people to be able to reach, see where people can reach from at peak traffic time. So 9 a.m. So if we change this from leaving to arriving, and this is just today's date, but we will put in this morning. And now we'll be able to, by clicking on this part, so this is just a drop down, on this we'll be able to now click as to where we want that location to go to. So we'll just zoom in on our point layer here, just to make it nice and simple for us. And then what I'll do is I'll just click it once, and there we go, that's already created a time map for us. So if we just zoom out, just clicking on this so that I can pan the map, and now you can see our travel time area. And this is what this is demonstrating, is how far from how far can we get to this arrival destination within 1 hour and on public transport at 9 a.m. And you can see just the difference in size and how those different points in terms of being granular and actually going all the way out to St. Albans, past Brentwood there, using public transport where you can get from to get to this office location. And this is just a great example of kind of why time is a better use than the traditional radius circle. For a number of different things. So it could be kind of commercial real estate or real estate. You want to look at, you know, the properties that you can reach an office. Traditional search sites will be only kind of looking at those radius circles or those distance areas. And you're actually missing out on a lot of different areas, which are obviously reachable within a 1 hour commute time, which is a very normal kind of commute time to do. You'll notice a couple of things about this time map is firstly the islands. So essentially what we're saying here is that's where there may be a train station and you can get on at that time and then get to that destination within an hour, though you can't actually get off at any point here, hence why there's the islands. And then also holes, and that's much the same in terms of you are able to get to a certain kind of train stop or train station, bus station, but you can't actually essentially walk into these areas. So it includes a walk for public transport and then another walk on the end. And with those areas that are kind of holes or donut kind of shaped holes is areas that you can't reach. So yeah, that's kind of just a very simple introduction into a radius circle versus using a travel time map or an isochrone. If you want to find out more, please just go onto traveltime.com/QGIS and docs, QGIS docs, and you'll be able to find out a little bit more about the other things and offerings that we have. Thanks so much.